Hello and welcome to the Grand Line Review, your source for everything One Piece, and today I am here to discuss a very bizarre situation within the One Piece media empire, which is a popular train of thought currently spreading around the fanbase that the anime has somehow actually managed to spoil the manga. Now, if this doesn't seem like an odd statement to you, I'd like to remind us all that this is generally impossible because the anime is always about a year behind on animating events that have already occurred in the manga. Therefore, there is no way that the anime could ever spoil manga readers. Yeah, well, maybe not. And all of this has come about with the most recent episode, 892. And as I'm sure we're all well aware, this officially commences the Wano arc in the anime, bringing sweeping positive changes to usher us into a brand new world of glory for this medium. And as part of this, we were also given a brand new opening called Over the Top by Hiroshi Kitatani. Now, unfortunately, this opening is riddled with spoilers from the very get-go. In fact, the very first shot has Luffy in prison, but it proceeds to show a spoiler rampage for the poor, poor anime-only watchers, going on to show Sanji's raid suit, Basil Hawkins, Yasu's moment, and even Kaido in dragon form. Now, I don't know if it's just a cultural thing that Japanese fans don't mind knowing everything they're about to watch, or even if these kind of spoilers are expected to generate interest in their viewing. Whatever the case, it kind of sucks for the foreign anime-only fans who have stood firmly by the series only to have this shoved in their faces. However, it may get even worse, because there is a dangerous idea floating around that this opening not only spoils anime fans, but also includes a massive manga spoiler as well. So how does it do this? Well, the idea is centered around these four stills. So we have Kinemon and Kiku, along with Kawamatsu, creepily in the middle there, and then we move to Shutenmaru and Kyoshiro, Nekomamushi and Inuarashi, and finally, Raizo and Kanjuro. Now, why does this mean anything at all? Well, individually, there's nothing so special about these split screens, but it is the fact that they are the only characters shown in this way, and when we look at them all together, there's a bit of a trend happening, being that eight of these nine characters happen to be members of the Nine Red Scabbards. So it appears that they're not just a random assortment of characters that were chosen to be featured in these little dual flashcard things. So we then need to ask ourselves, why is Kyoshiro here? And from here, a lot of people have put two and two together and come to the conclusion that it's because, well, Kyoshiro is the final member of the Nine Red Scabbards, who has not yet been revealed to us in the manga, although we do know that his name is supposedly Denjiro. Not that having a different name matters at all, because we have aliases everywhere in the Wano arc, and even amongst the confirmed Nine Red Scabbards, we have one with Shutenmaru being an alias for Ashura Doji. Now, I have to say, when I initially heard this thought, I dismissed it outright as another one of those stupid fan ideas, because just believe me, there's a lot of them. However, this is because I wasn't paying complete attention to the opening. Watching it for the first time, I completely missed Kawamatsu in between Kinemon and Kiku, so I just thought to myself, no. If they were going to highlight the Red Scabbards, they would just use Kawamatsu's silhouette with Ashura Doji instead of Kyoshiro. But after spotting that Kawamatsu is indeed there, I can't deny that there is a very deliberate effort to highlight these characters as being part of a cohesive group. And of course, the other reason why I dismissed it at first is because the silhouettes we've seen of Denjiro don't match up to Kyoshiro, because he seems to have a big ponytail type thing. But then again, silhouettes in One Piece are notoriously unreliable. And of course, it's also possible that Kyoshiro is in some sort of disguise to hide his more, say, recognizable form. I mean, just imagine if that hair was simply a really bad wig. But also, Kyoshiro may not necessarily have to be Denjiro in order to be one of the Nine Red Scabbards. Denjiro could have passed away, and Kyoshiro is carrying on his will. A very prevalent idea in One Piece. And so that also makes some sense, because Kyoshiro appears to be much younger than the rest of the Scabbards, and you know, maybe the thing that Ashura Doji wants to show Kinemon is Denjiro's grave. And that also works in relation to why Kyoshiro has that weird connection with Hiyori, although I will say that it doesn't explain why Hiyori has no idea where Denjiro is, unless of course Kyoshiro is strategically not telling her. But hey, she also didn't know where Ashura Doji was, so she clearly isn't all that well informed on the matter. But there is a fair bit of substance to the idea. So I can't believe I'm saying this, but I think it's entirely possible that the anime has just spoiled the manga. It's an absurd thought, but it's very possible. Now, the next point of resistance would be, how did the anime know that Kyoshiro was one of the Nine Red Scabbards, given that we as manga readers don't even know yet? And that can be explained because the anime is often privy to random bits of information from Oda in order to plan their product far ahead. So I can see a situation in which an anime team are planning the opening, and Oda informs them that Kyoshiro is indeed the final member of the Nine Red Scabbards, with the plan in mind that Oda himself would have revealed it in the manga by the time the opening is actually reaching broadcast. The evidence I have to support this is the idea that Oda is a legendarily poor predictor of time, and if they were planning the opening months and months ago, I feel like it is feasible that he would have gone, look, this is where the manga will be at that point in time. And so the anime team ran with it, because as established, they love cramming as many spoilers as possible into the openings. And look, I don't like to get carried away with these sorts of thoughts, because 99% of the time, they'll turn out to be heavily coincidental connections made by people like me who have far too much time on their hands. However, this situation just fascinates me because it is so oddly plausible. Try as I might, I cannot think of a good reason as to why Kyoshiro is included in this particular part of the opening, alongside this particular set of characters, rather than having his own focus elsewhere in the opening, like maybe alongside Orochi. The anime team know that he is an important antagonistic figure, so why bury him in this montage of good guys? I mean, maybe it was a practical consideration, like we don't have the space to showcase him, so where can we put him? Maybe alongside Usher Adolji, because he also comes off as somewhat antagonistic in the beginning of Wano, but that is legitimately the best reason I can come up with, other than it was a random choice, and they did not think through the connotations that they would be drawing, which I find very difficult to believe in this current incarnation of the animation team, and it's because of the huge attention to detail that they've used with showcasing every other spoiler that we're already aware of in the opening. They have gone well out of their way to make sure that this opening is depicting very accurate events and characters, so I currently don't see why this moment would be any different. And before I get swamped with arguments like, nah mate, Sanji was shown fighting Kizaru in an opening before and that didn't happen, so therefore based on that one horrible example, it is also the case here as well. And the two situations are just completely different. Like I said, whether this was intentional or not on the part of the animation team, and I do believe it was, taking into account the rest of the opening, it looks intentional. Because hey, if they did want to show the scabbards, then instead of Kyoshiro, why not use the silhouette of Denjiro, like they did with Koamatsu? There is just so much that either points to some of the poorest possible thinking in the world by the animation staff, or that this was a very intentional move because Oda may have told them that by now he would have revealed Kyoshiro. So yeah, I am endlessly intrigued by this idea because it may very well be the first time that I have ever experienced having the manga spoiled by the anime, and it would certainly be something unique if it turned out to be true. But I just want to be clear, I am not 100% investing in this idea as many other people have, because it is far from confirmed. But there is a lot to say that it could very well be the case, and to find out, I guess we'll just have to stay tuned to the manga. Because if this is correct, I have a feeling that we are going to know very, very soon. But that pretty much does it for this crazy topic on whether or not the One Piece anime may have somehow spoiled the manga. If you enjoyed this video and the content this channel produced in general, then please do consider donating to the Grand Line Review Patreon, because the support of all of you amazing people is what continues to make this channel possible. And if you'd like to see more videos like this but apply to other anime manga series, then please do check out my second channel, New World Review, for all of your wider needs. And if you'd like to join the fun at any time, then please do head over to my Discord server, where a wide array of shenaniganry takes place on a daily basis. And finally, please do comment with your thoughts on whether or not the One Piece anime may have spoiled the manga. This has been the Grand Line Review, and I'll see you next time.